Hello guys, welcome back once again. This is Jagrat here, and previously we have seen the concept of radio button in the previous session. Okay, so in this session we will see the concept of checkboxes. How can we select the checkboxes? How can we deselect the checkboxes? And we will do some experiments over these checkboxes also. Okay, so let me create a class. Let us suppose my class name is checkbox. Okay, checkbox. Let us suppose this is my class name. Click on public static void main and then click on finish. Okay, so again, let me copy this code and let me paste here. So again guys, we will see the example of this site, demo.automationtesting.in. okay, so this is a registration page and you can see here these are the checkboxes. Okay, and guys, we can select as many as checkboxes that we want. Okay, you can select this also, you can select this also, you can select this also. Okay, so at a time you can select as many as checkboxes that you want. Okay, so let me refresh this page. So these are the checkboxes. Okay, so guys, let us suppose if we want to select this checkbox. Okay, so let me show you that how can we specify this element. So you can see here, type is equal to checkbox, id is equal to checkbox 1, and value is equal to cricket. Okay, now let us suppose if we talk about the second, and type is equal to checkbox, id is equal to checkbox 2, values is equal to movies, and now third is id is equal to checkbox and value is equal to hockey. So guys, you can see here we can either specify these checkboxes with the help of id also, because id you can see unique for all these three checkboxes, as well as we can specify all these checkboxes with the help of values, because values are also different. Okay, so either we can use id or we can use value. So let's see. So again guys, I'm using the shortcut method. Okay, so driver dot find element. Okay, by dot, let us suppose I am using id. Okay, id, and what is the id? Let me copy the id name. So this is, let us suppose I want to select this checkbox, cricket checkbox. So id is checkbox 1. So let me paste here, and what we will want to do, what we want to do, click. Okay, we have to click the checkbox. Okay, so this is the syntax to check the checkboxes. Okay, let us suppose I want to select this movies checkbox also. So this time I will take the concept of movie value. Okay, so let us suppose driver dot find element. Okay, by dot, this time I will use x path. Okay, so what will be the x path? Let me make the x path for this. So control F. So let us suppose this is input. Okay, at the rate value is equal to, this is movies. Okay, so you can see here 1 of 1. So this is the x path for movies checkbox. Okay, so you can see here it is indicating the checkbox. Okay, so let me copy this and paste this here. And what actually we want to do, we have to click. Okay guys, so this is the syntax to select the checkbox. Okay. So let me run this and let's see whether these two checkboxes are getting selected or not. You can see here browser is maximized and now it will launch the proper site. So you can see here site is launched. Okay. Guys, you can see here these two checkboxes are selected. See, okay. So this is the thing. Now guys, let us suppose I want to uncheck this checkbox. Okay. So what method we will do? Let us suppose I want to check this checkbox, then we have to click on it. And let us suppose if we want to uncheck this checkbox, so again I have to click on it. Okay. So let me put some weight so that you can see the effect. So this is sleep method. Yeah. So this is sleep method that I am going to incorporate. Okay, and let me add the declaration. And now I want to uncheck cricket checkbox. Okay, so again I will perform the click operation. Okay guys, so let me run this program and let's see the effect. So Chrome driver is launched, it's maximized. Now it is going to launch demo.automationtesting.in. Okay, so you can see here. Site is launched. See, these are selected and now cricket is unselected. Okay, cricket is unchecked. Okay guys, so I told you till now how can we select the checkbox and how can we deselect the checkbox. Okay, so again, the next concept is, let us suppose, how can we know that whether any particular checkbox is selected or not? Okay, so in the interview, at the time of interview, they will ask that how can we know that whether any particular checkbox is selected or not? Okay, so let me comment this. So let us suppose I want to know whether this checkbox one means cricket checkbox is selected or not. Okay. So driver dot find element. Guys, please see very carefully that how can we know. Okay. So firstly we will locate that element. Okay. And dot is selected method. There is a method called is selected. Okay, is selected method is used to identify whether any particular checkbox is selected or not. Okay, and guys, you can see here it will return boolean. It will return boolean. Okay, so we need to store this value. Let us suppose boolean b1. Okay, and now I am going to print the value of b1. Okay, so if the checkbox is selected, then b1 will return true, otherwise b1 will return false. Okay, so let me comment this thing also and this thing also. Okay, so what this code will do, this will check the checkbox and then it will check whether checkbox is selected. So yes, checkbox is selected, so it will return b1 is equal to 2. Okay, so let me run this program again. Guys, these methods are very important. Okay, so you need to remember it, that how can we check whether any particular checkbox is selected or not. So with the help of isSelected method. Okay, so Chrome browser is launched. Maximized. Now it is going to launch the URL. So let's wait to see the output. Okay. See, site is launched. Cricket is selected. And now let's see the value of b1. See, b1 is equal to true. Okay, because this checkbox is selected. Okay, guys. If this is not selected, then it will return false. Let us suppose this will check the cricket checkbox select, and again we are going to select this, so this will uncheck. Okay, so now the b1 value should be false. Okay, so let's run this again. So guys, that's why you know, I am again running the program again and again, so that you can clearly understand the effect of coding. Okay, so if you will do the experiment, then only you will know that what actually happening. Okay, please do the experiments in your coding. So let's see the effect and let's see the output of b1. Okay, so site is launched, it will select cricket checkbox, then it will deselect. See, it is select, it is deselect. Okay, and now let's see the output. See, false, because cricket checkbox is not selected. Okay, is unchecked. Okay guys, so with the help of isSelected method, we can know whether any particular checkbox is selected or not. Okay, so now guys, at the last, we will take some real time scenario. Okay, so guys, we need to make a code that if any particular checkbox is selected, then it will print checkbox is selected, and if it is not already selected, then it will firstly select and then it will print checkbox is selected now. Okay, so let's build the code for this problem statement. So our problem statement is, we will launch a site, we will see whether any particular checkbox is selected or not. Okay, if it is selected, it will print the message that checkbox is selected. Okay, and if it will not be selected, then it will print the message that checkbox is not selected, then it will select the checkbox, and then it will print now checkbox is selected. Okay, so this is our problem statement. Now let's make the code for this. Okay guys, so let me comment this. Okay, so firstly it will check the checkbox, then it will check whether checkbox is selected or not, and it will print the code. So here I am putting one if else condition. So b1 is equal to true. If b1 is equal to true, it means checkbox is already selected. So system.out.println. Okay, and here I will write the message that checkbox is selected. Okay, else I will print the message that checkbox is not selected. Okay, and after this we will perform the selection of checkboxes. So let me copy this again and like this. So if checkbox will not select, then it will select the checkbox, and again it will print the message that now checkbox is selected. Okay, now checkbox is selected. Okay guys, so this is the code. So in the current scenario, if we will run this program, what it will do, let's see. Okay, so it will launch the site, then it will click the checkbox. Okay, so is selected returns true. So what is the value of b1? True. So if it is the true, then it should be give the output that checkbox is selected in this case. Okay, so let's run this and let's see the output. Site is going to launch. So guys, this code is very important. When you will build the real-time applications, then you have to incorporate this code. Okay, because sometimes what happens in some sites, some default checkbox is present and that is already selected. Okay, so you have to incorporate this code. So you can see here, this will select the cricket checkbox. And now let's see the output. See, checkbox is selected. Okay guys, so it is giving that checkbox is selected. Okay, now let me uncomment this line. Okay, so now what it will do, see, it will launch the site, then it will check the checkbox, cricket checkbox, then it will uncheck the cricket checkbox. Okay, so what will be the value of b1? B1 is equal to false. So if b1 is equal to false, then it will move towards the else block. So it will print first checkbox is not selected, then it will check the checkbox, and then it will print the message that now checkbox is selected. Okay, so let's run this program again. Let's see the output. Okay, so it is maximized. Site is going to launch. Okay, so site is launched. You can see here, firstly it will select, then unselect, then again select, and now let's see the output. See, b1 is equal to false. Okay, So it will jump into this. So checkbox is not selected. Okay. Then it will check the checkboxes. So let's see. See, checkbox is selected now, and it will throw the message that now checkbox is selected. Okay, guys. So this code is very important. Okay. So in this session, what we learned, how to check the checkboxes, how to uncheck the checkboxes, how can we check whether any particular checkboxes is selected or not, and we developed a code to check whether if particular checkbox is selected, then it will print checkbox is selected message, and if the checkbox is not selected, then it will print checkbox is not selected, then it will check the checkbox, and then finally it will print the message that now checkbox is selected. Okay guys, so that's all about this session. So let me mark it as completed. Okay, so guys, if you really like this video, then please like, share and subscribe. Okay, so in the further sessions we will see the concept of drop down. Okay, so please practice this, and see you in the next session. Bye bye.